Hello friends, so in chapter 7 about values in Python, I welcome you all. So in this video, we will just discuss what values are there in a Python. Say you haven't learned or you haven't read about the literal terms in C++, C or Java, if you are from that background. If not, then you will understand what values are. But basically, if you know what literals are, then generally literals and values in Python are similar. Okay, so what literals were there? Literals were basically the values that we provide to the variables. Okay, say we have a equals to 5, then 5 was a literal. Okay, a is equals to 5.5, then 5.5 was a literal. So a was the integer literal, 5 was the integer literal, 5.5 was the floating point literal. Same, we have values in Python. And same, we have integer values, floating values, string values, and so on. That means the values that we give to the variables, right? So what integer values are? Integers are the whole numbers. Whole numbers means they will not have the fractional part in them. That means we cannot say 5.5 is a whole number. That means 5.5 is not an integer. Integer could either be negative, either be positive or zero, but it should not be fractional part. Okay, so Python supports a number of numeric and non-numeric values. In particular, Python programs can use integer values, right? For example, you can simply say that print 4. 4 is here an integer value. We are not using any quotation mark in that case, because if you will apply quotation mark, it will be a different value. But right now, without quotation mark, it's a positive whole number. That's why it will be called an integer value. Okay, so whenever we work with Python, there is a shell in which we type our commands. That is called interactive shell. We have already discussed about interactive shell in previous videos. So how interactive shell works? Okay, the working of interactive shell is reading the text that we enter. Okay, it attempts to evaluate the user's input in context of what user has entered up to that point. And then it prints the evaluation of the user's input. Say, for example, a user enters 4. Okay, so if it is entering a simple integer value, it will simply print it. So when the user enters 4, the shell interprets it as a 4. But if user enters x is equals to 10, now what the interpreter will interpret? The shell will interpret it as a value that is being assigned to a variable. So it will not do anything. It will just assign value 10 to x. Right? So after that, whenever you will print x, you will get the value 10, because x is being assigned a value 10 to it. After that, if a user tries to print the value of y, the shell reports an error because y is not being declared till yet. Right? So as we do with earlier programming languages, we simply have to declare a variable. We can assign different kind of values to that variable. Not as Java or C++, Python do not have the direct concept of declarations of data types. We are not going to declare it as int x or float x or double x and so on. We simply give it the value and it automatically interprets which kind of value it is storing. And so according to that, which kind of data type it will be, but the values will be similar to that one. Okay, now there are single quotes and double quotes. If we'll specifically say about string values, you have single and double quotes in that one. Okay, in other languages, we normally have either single quotes or either double quotes, but in Python recognizes both the single quotes and double quotes as a valid way to delimit a string value. So this is for string value. Whenever you are trying to store or assign a string value to a variable, it must be in either single quote or in double quote. But the rule is this, that if you are using single quotes, then starting and ending both will be single quotes. If you are using double quotes, if you are starting the string with the double quotes, it must be ended with double quotes. So both the sides, it will be single. You cannot mix them up. You cannot use one single quote and another double quotes, or starting with double quotes, ending with single quotes. In that case, it will be error. So as you can see, we are starting with single quotes, ending with single quotes, starting with double quotes, ending with double quotes. But if you are using single quotes from starting point and double quotes for ending point, you are getting a syntax error. Okay, so support of single and double quote is there, but if you are using one, it should be ended with that, right? Okay, next thing is, how can we convert int to string or string to int? We have read till yet that we have number values, we have string values. If you wish to convert a string value to a number value or a number value to a string value, how can we do that? So Python provide us two specific functions for that purpose, str and int. Str takes an integer argument, as you can see here that in interactive shell we are given str of 4. Then what it is doing, it is converting it to a string. And in another way, we are using int of a string value, and it is returning us the integer value. Okay, so these two are basically the built-in functions that is used to convert integer to string and string to integer expressions. There is an operator like plus. You all know that plus is basically used for concatenation purpose in case the inputs are strings, and to add two values or numbers if they are integer or float. The same plus operator in Python 2. If you are using 2 plus 4, two number values, it will add them. If you are using 2 plus 4, two string values, then it will concatenate them. If you are using two different strings, it will again concatenate them. But the thing is this, that we cannot use one integer value, another string value for plus operator. In that case, it will be a syntax error. So how can we do that? We must have to convert one into another. Either we have to convert this integer to string first, or this string to integer first, as we have done here. 5 plus int 6 will give you 11. First it will convert 6 to integer value, and then that integer value will be added to another integer value, and then you will get the result. How to know the type of value? The value that you are using, you are using number value, you are using string value, how will you know that which class it belongs to? We have a predefined type function. It will determine the type of most complicated expressions. So if you are using type 4, it will return you class int. If you are using type string value, it will guess class str. Even with the expression, it is giving you what the resultant value of that. So the type is used for getting the class which the specific expression or the value represents. So guys, this was about the values in Python. In next video, we will discuss what variables and how to assign variables, how to assign values and expressions to different variables. So thank you for watching. Keep likes and subscribe. Thank you very much.